So I was trying to get at, it's about how the carbohydrates metabolize into sugar. Is it correct?
Correct.
Yes, you all get that? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Let her know we'll be there in about 3 minutes. Okay. All right. So it's all about how the carbohydrates, you know, metabolize into the sugar. Now, this test is generally done on women that are pregnant. Have you had one done? Anybody?
Yes.
And did you have a 2-hour or 6-hour, or did you have to eat food versus taking a drink?
No, mine was the 4-hour.
4 hours.
But they made me, no, it was 2-hour because I stayed there. They made me drink it and like sit there for 2 hours.
Exactly. Okay. Sometimes they'll make you drink or they'll make you eat a meal.
Okay. Yeah.
And the doctor decides this, you know. We don't get there and like, I want you to eat today, or I want you to drink today. The doctor is the one to decide that.
They sent me home with that.
You could, and then you came back after the 2 hours.
Yeah.
Okay, alrighty. So you understand there's many different ways or methods that this test that can be done, and a doctor is the one to decide it, okay? But once the patient gets to us, what we have to do is make sure the patient is fasting, okay? It's really important that that patient has been fasting for 8 to 12 hours if we're going to give them the drink at the facility, okay? Of course, you wouldn't be fasting if you had it to drink yourselves, okay? Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
All right, some of the patient instructions are, once that we've established their fasting, that they can, of course, have nothing to eat while they're there. You need to make sure if you're doing a sixth-hour test that patient knows they're going to be pretty much there the whole day with you. Okay? Make sure that they don't smoke. And, you know, of course, like I just said, they're usually pregnant. So, and you don't want to go there. Don't touch pregnant and smoking. Don't go there. Just let them know that they can't smoke. If you were to, you know, draw them and you could smell smoke on their breath, you should note that in notation. But just go ahead with the test. Let the supervisor know, and you know, let somebody else make the decision. But the test still will probably be done. No chewing gum. Mm-hmm. They can have water only if they really do need it. And if they throw up the drink, the test is going to be canceled. So you got to tell them, you know, all of these things before you start the procedure. Okay? We're good so far? The other thing of it is we're going to have to stick these people, if it's for an 8-hour, if it's a 6-hour test, we're going to stick them 8 times. 8 times.
6-hour test is 8 times.
Yes. And you have the fasting, half hour, 1 hour, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That would be 8 times. So it's advantageous for a phlebotomist to tie the tourniquet and figure out where you're going to draw them. Because, you know, if you're sticking them in the same arm and you're doing like this and you're tying a tourniquet, that's going to get very irritating to them, probably in their third to sixth hour. You get what I mean? Because you're going to have to line up. And if they don't have good veins like me, then you might have to get 2 out of here, maybe 2 here, maybe 2 here. I don't even know where you're going to get the other 2 from. So it can get that hard with various people. So know where you're going to stick them so it's less tying and untying tourniquet and probing. Okay? Now you've established that, you'll go ahead and do the fasting blood draw. Okay? You'll go ahead and do the fasting blood draw. It's very important that we label the tubes with the time and interval. The time, and we'll just keep up with the time that's on the page. Let's say it's 7:55, okay, that we drew the fasting. You get that? So I want to put, of course, it's labeled with their identifying full name, date of birth. If it's an outpatient, might not have that MRN, probably won't have that MRN. But you put fasting, and what time that is 7:55. You get what I mean? The last thing you want to have are a bunch of gray top tubes, or we could use actually the gold tube, and you don't know which ones are which. That would be a very bad thing. So you understand why the time and the intervals are very important, okay? So now they've done a fasting. While I'm doing the labeling, I can give the drink to the patient for them to drink it, okay? They have 5 minutes. You want to make sure they do it within that 5 minutes. Then you can go and have the patient go to the, I don't bandage the patient because you're going to be putting on and taking that off pretty recently, and that's another thing that can irritate or, you know, annoy them. All right, so I'm going to tell the patient to go and sit in a waiting area. I'm going to give them a bell or some kind of, you know, a bell. That way, if they're feeling sick, you know, I'm not going to be looking at them the whole time they're there. If they're feeling sick, something's wrong, they can ring a bell, and we'll come to them, okay? We're also going to make a timeline on a piece of paper. We're going to make a timeline of, you know, the next next 7 draws, okay? The next one is going to be the half an hour at 8:30, the 1 hour at 9 o'clock, and so on and so on. And we're going to set a bell or a timer there, too, because someone else could do the draw. You're just not attached to the patient. Someone else can do the draw. You're going to have a break. You're going to have a lunch. You get what I mean? Mm-hmm. But as soon as the bell rings, we'll know. And it's good to start about 5 minutes earlier so you can get the patient back. You can have them seated. So by the time the half an hour actually gets there, the bell rings, you can be ready to do that draw. Okay? Does that make sense to everybody? Mm-hmm. All right. And like I said, when the bell, the 25 minutes of the bell, we're going to call them back. It can be you or somebody else. It says right here what time to draw. Then the bell went off too, and continue on with the process. Does that make sense to you? Mm-hmm.